gotta be the mind. I ask like that, gotta be one of the kind. I crush it every time, punch it with every nine. I'm fucking with their mind.
And all those secrets now, God please, God be right. And she looks like her on my dream. My nightmares, think it was my nightmares. And I think I need your love, I don't need no one selfish. Wonder if I can just know my heart, cause she here.
Snow, so picturesque is the right word for it. Today I'm checking out and enjoying the sights and sounds of the town called Hamilton, New York, the village, which was founded back in 1795, and Forbes magazine named this to be one of the friendliest villages in the United States. It's a little chilly. It's located in Madison County, which is the home of Colgate University, a very popular college. The population here in this beautiful town in Hamilton is roughly 5,000. This town is also known for a movie that was shot here back in 2017 It's actually the perfect Christmas comedy. It's called Pottersville and had some big names. The cast consisted of Michael Shannon, who played in one of my favorite shows, The Boardwalk Empire, among a ton of other movies. Ron Perlman, who was in another favorite show of mine, Sons of Anarchy. That show really got me into buying a motorcycle, but that's a whole different story. Also, Judy Greer, who played in 13 Going on 30 and What Women Want. But anyways, it's a funny movie about Bigfoot, and you should check it out. This is a very safe town, very family-friendly town, and I can't wait to check out the sites and the architecture and learn a little bit about its history. So join me. Post office of Hamilton, New York. All right, let's go into the downtown region and do a little exploring. There's a nice mural. Yes, so there was a big fire that knocked out most of these buildings. You did read about that. The Great Fire of 1895. And it was rebuilt shortly after the fire. And I don't have to tell you folks that this town was named after Alexander Hamilton. What is this, Whole Foods store? So it's Christmas weekend and not too many people are out and about, because it's absolutely freezing, but that's okay. We can weather the elements. What is this? Crush Bottle Shop. Wine and liquor store. Looks like a very nice, clean, kept town. This is the Broad Street Diner. Let's see what kind of goodies they sell. Avocado, huh? Avocado toast. Too bad they're closed, but we'll carry on. If you like Indian food, if you like spicy food, come to Hamilton. This over here. Anything going on around town? Street alley. Ooh, that looks cool. It's closed. Can I walk through it? Only one way to find out. Only one way to find out. Ooh, look at that. There's a bunch of businesses back here. But yeah, the alley in Hamilton. What is that? A spaceship. Well, we got to see the alley. We can pretty much go home now. This is there. It used to be an opera house. Now, it's a movie theater. This is where all the entertainment happens. Happy Holidays 2020. Wonderland. 1984. Do you want to see that? Friends and food, Vietnamese cuisine. Closed right now, but I do love that. Can we take a peek inside this historic establishment? It's basically a movie theater. It's cool. I know movie theaters are going to be a thing of the past soon. They're closing down with all the Netflix and Hulu and all these other apps where you can pretty much watch whatever you want on your phone. Unfortunately, the movie theater industry is not doing too good. Damn school. Alright, Oliveri's Pizza. If you try a slice, give it a nice little rating. Wow, that was that dude's pretending he didn't see me. It's like, oh man, this thing busted. A lot of salons, a lot of artsy buildings and arts and crafts and plush little town. That's the best way to describe Hamilton. And it's really a small city. My understanding is they have their own they have their own utility company, sir. So they're self-sufficient, and they like to call themselves an independent city. There's a little joint called Hamilton Eatery. And there is another mural, Chenango Canal. Is it Canal? 1837 to 1878. The Erie Canal. And this picture can be renovated. Give it some fresh colors with all these arts and crafts. Russia's Bar and Grill. Sports, spirits. Let's take a look at the menu. Mac and cheese bites. I'm definitely checking out the pizza place. Got some sandwiches here. Reuben's, my faves. Nice. That's Russia's Bar and Grill. All right. Phoenix Block. Another bar called the Hourglass. That's cool. Risky Business. And the pizzeria, Oliveri's Pizzeria. I'm not sure if they're open. I'm not eating outside. I think dining in is closed, but we'll give it a try. We'll check out their main pizza spot. Got my Oliveri's. What is this? Antique animals. Got my Oliveri's Pizza. We'll give it a try in just a moment. Just gotta find a place to put my bottle down somewhere and see how good the pizza is in Hamilton, New York. Alright, this should do. Plant my rear and give it a bite. Let's see how good this pizza is. Ooh, super thin. I love it. That's my favorite type. Thin crust. Let's check it out.
swirl.
Gotta fold it. Wow, very impressed. I'm actually impressed. Trying not to eat like a pig over here, but slices are a little small, I'm not gonna lie. Should be at least 20% larger, but the taste makes up for it. You can taste the sauce, the cheese. Oh man, I gotta give this bad boy 8.1. This pizza is amazing. Let's carry on. Gotta finish my slices. Get that energy. Look at all the people out and about enjoying this beautiful weather, this beautiful little city. Oh, look at this, another mural. Very pretty. Back at mine, 1865. Hotel Maxwell. That's a nice historic building. Not mine checking out. If it's open, if they let me in. We'll see. Colgate lacrosse, ice hockey and football. Oh, the man, the myth, the legend, Bob Ross. Used to watch this guy when I was a kid. Back in the early 90s. And I was wowed at every piece of his artwork, which he performed effortlessly. The pizza. All right, we're at the arts building here. It's called the Arts at the Palace Theater. So this is where a lot of folks in Hamilton come for their theatrical performance. Time to cross the famous bookstore that I read about. Chinese restaurant. What is this here? Fountain Company, number one. Fire Company. Taco place. Not too many people to speak to, or, you know, but everyone's home hanging out with the fam. It's Christmas weekend, so. What is this? Oh, coffee roasters. Okay. You need a cup of joe. You got a place to go. We are Madison and Utica Street. And this is a 3-star hotel. Built in 1925, and it's a Dutch colonial with a tavern and a restaurant. It's in the heart of Hamilton. It looks absolutely beautiful from the outside.
library.
Hi, how are you today? Better than I deserve. It's cold out there. 3-star hotel, right? It should be 5-star. It should be 5-star. Yeah, I'm not sure why they said 3-star in Google. Give this place 5 stars. It's absolutely incredible. There's a painting. Wow, this is known as the library. Conversation, or maybe not so quiet. Piano. Christmas tree. Look at this building. I should have brought my ice skates. Residential block. This is the village. The village office closed, but it's definitely a National Historical Foundation building, built in 1850. Now off to the Batmobile for a new adventure. Manor on the Green. Look at this building. Manor on the Green, 1825. Look at that roof. Wow. I don't think you can visit Hamilton without checking out Colgate University, built in 1819. Check out the campus, why don't we? Very beautiful buildings. Very pretty up here. Look at the scenery. There's a little story about Colgate. I don't know too many details, but there were 13 founders, and apparently they had $13 and some kind of 13 documents when they established this university, this private university. And so the saying is that 13 is a very lucky number for Colgate. Beautiful campus. According to Wikipedia, the tuition here in Colgate is $24,000. I don't know how outdated that information is. They say the graduation rate is 90%. Graduation rate is 90%, which is amazing, and to say the least. So the students must have a huge support network here. And acceptance rate, this school is not very easy to get accepted into. 25% of folks get accepted. So, but this is the main squad right here, where most students picnic in the summertime, play frisbee, throw the football, and just enjoy the outdoors and bonding time with their fellow classmates.
Some good SAT scores to get into Colgate.
There's almost as many students in Colgate University as there are residents in the town of Hamilton. So this school is a huge financial bedrock for the town of Hamilton. And that's probably why there are so many bars in downtown. But it's cold, so I'm gonna have that. There's a very Yale Harvard view. Not sure how many acres are.